Praise the Lord, brothers and sisters in the Lord. I bless you in the name of Jesus. Once again, this is your usual host, Mrs. Evangelist Egoman. I want to thank God for making our head to read this new year. I have come here once again with another word of God, a word from God, which I know, as we just luckily tune in now, to this word of exhortation I'm about to give, I know you'll be blessed in Jesus' name. But before I go for the word, I want to sing to glorify the name of the Lord. Just listen and be blessed in Jesus' name. Amen. My God, who began it, He will accomplish it. I say, my God, who began it, He will accomplish it. He is the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. He will accomplish it. He will accomplish it. I say, my God who began it, He will accomplish it. My God who began it, He will accomplish it. He is the Alpha Omega, the beginning and the end. He will accomplish it. He will accomplish it. Amen. Once again, viewers all over the world, your usual host, Mrs. Evangelist Egoman, have come once again to give you a word from God. I know when you avail yourself to listen to this one word from God, there are many things that you began to experience in your life. Victory, success, upliftment, etc. You will see. Amen, somebody. I want to give an exhortation which I titled, Christ in You, the Hope of Glory. Christ in Me, the Hope of Glory. I repeat, Christ in You, the Hope of Glory. Quickly, I want to open to the book of Isaiah chapter 43. I want to read from verse 1 to 3. Just listen and be blessed in Jesus' name. Meanwhile, if you don't have a Bible, I want you to pause it. Go and bring your Bible and turn it on again so that you can join me. Amen, somebody. Isaiah 43, verse 1 to 3. Amen. But now, this is what the Lord says. He who created you, O Jacob, He who formed you, Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have summoned you by name. You are mine. Two, when you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. The flame will not set you ablaze. Three, the last one, for I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I give Egypt for your ransom, Cush and Saba in your stead. Amen, somebody. Praise the Lord, somebody. Once again, I told you earlier that I have titled this message, this exhortation, Christ in You, the Hope of Glory. The word of God in the book of Isaiah chapter 43, if you read from verse 1 to 3, God Almighty sent prophet Isaiah to go and tell the Israelites, as a believer of Christ, you are the Israelites of today, that He is there for you. No matter what you are passing through, He is there to bring you out of it. Brethren, beloveds, and brothers and mothers in the Lord, sisters, children, as you tune on this word of exhortation, you count yourself lucky to listen to this word of God that God has sent me as Prophet Elijah of Isaiah of today to come and tell you that He is there for you. Whether you are falling in hot water, whether you are falling in the sea, no matter what you are passing through, God said that if you have Christ in you, that is the glory you have, that He is always there for you. Beloved brothers and sisters in the Lord, I don't know who is watching me right now. You just luckily tune in to see this word of exhortation that is coming from Mrs. Evangelist Segun, and God has sent me to come and tell you this hour that you have to choose him first, because the word of God said in the scripture that choose first the kingdom of God and other things will follow. Brothers and sisters, if you have not yet given your life to God, I want you to confess with your mouth as you believe in your heart that he has sent his beloved son from heaven, Jesus Christ, to come and die for you. I want you to confess with your mouth and declare it that God Almighty is your Lord and personal Savior. You have declared it and victory will be yours forever. You began to use the word of God to walk in his principle, his rules, and his regulation. God has sent Isaiah to come and tell the Israelites, and I'm here representing the Isaiahs of today, because God have ordained me as an evangelist to come and be telling his children, using the word of God to come and be releasing, removing pain and sorrow out of their mind, to give them that spirit of boldness and faithfulness to use in their daily activities. God said he's there for you 24 hours. Brothers and sisters, I don't know what you are passing through. I don't know whatever you are going through right now, but I'm here to give you a good news. As you use the word of God to move in your daily activity, God said he's with you. I want to remember you of something. And let me go to the book of Genesis. I will read it to your hearing. This time around, God spoke to Jacob. He told him in the book of Genesis chapter 35, if you read one verse there, you will see it's not my word, it's the word of God. Praise the Lord, somebody. I'm sorry. It's my glass. I have to clean it very well. Praise the Lord. If you go to the book of Genesis chapter 35 verse 2, so Jacob said to his household and to all who were with him, get rid of the foreign gods you have with you, and purify yourself and change your clothes. 3. Then come, let us go up to Bethel, where I will build an altar to God, who answered me in the days of distress, who has been with me whenever I have gone. So they gave Jacob all the foreign gods they had and rings in their ear, and Jacob buried them under the oak of Chechen. Amen. This time around, God is telling Jacob to leave Chechen and go to Bethel. What am I saying? He told him to not to go with other foreign things, things that are negative, things that is not acceptable to God Almighty. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, this is a new year. I just thank God for your life, as many that have opportunity to enter this new year. I say, may the name of the Lord be glorified once again in Jesus' name. I have come with you to tell you one word from God, which I titled Christ in You, the Hope of Glory. We read the book of Isaiah chapter 43, where God said Isaiah to go and tell the Israelites that he is there with them, that even though they are passing through pain and sorrow, he is always there with them, if only they abide in him, his rules and his regulation. And I still took you to the book of Genesis chapter 35. We read verse 2 and 3. When God spoke to Jacob to tell him and his household to leave Chechem and go to Bethel. Bethel is the house of God. Bethel is dwelling in the things of God. Bethel is applying the wisdom, the principles and rules and regulations of God, and doing things that God said we should be doing. He said those things that did not belong to him, that we should leave them aside. I don't know what you are still carrying. If you are a gossiper, if you are the one that is having anger, if you are the one that is intimidating people with witchcraft, if you are the one that are envying people, I don't know the character that you are still carrying that is not pleasing to the eyes of God. Last time we spoke about Joshua in the book of Joshua chapter 24, we saw how God sent Joshua to go and tell the Israelites that God saw that they were dying in sin. God put them under bondages. But God is a merciful God. In that scripture, God sent Joshua to go and tell them, if only they can leave all those things behind, they should come to him. He will accept them. Our God is a God of love. Christ in you, the hope of glory. When you have Christ in you, when you walk in rules and in regulation, when you walk in his principle, God is not interested in whatever is around you that is fighting against you. He is there to set you free. He is there to uplift you. He is there to take you out of those predicament, those pain and sorrow. He is there. I don't know if you understand it. Many people in the scripture, we saw example of Esther when a man called Haman was trying to oppress them when they were in Esther under the leadership of Nebuchadnezzar. They fasted and they prayed. They so believed in God, they purified themselves. Under many, they were in exile, but they believe in that God so much that they don't want anything to take them out of that waste. So God saw them through. I'm here to encourage you with the word of God that Christ in you is a hope of glory. I don't know what you are passing through. We saw what Job passed through. This is Job in the book of Job. If we look at the book of Job chapter 29, he said, I think chapter 29 verse 3, he said, the lamp is on my head and his light will walk me out of darkness. But when he was passing through those temptations that the devil threw to him, praise the Lord somebody, the wife said, curse God and die. The friend spoke to Job that he has sinned against God. But Job still bowed down to pray to God. I don't know the difficulties you are passing through, but I'm here to encourage you with the word of God that the faith that Job was having was what gave him that Christ in him, in the hope of glory. He was having that spirit of God in him. He was so having confidence in the Lord. He did not allow the circumstances. The Bible said Job lost all his material things, including all his children, but yet he did not utter any bad word to God Almighty. Rather, he keep on seeking the face of God. Rather, he keep on praying to God day in and day out. If you read the book of chapter 1 to chapter 42, even in the end, you will saw where they write the dialogue that God spoke to Job to go and tell all those friends, all those where they uttered the sacrifice they will make. God is a merciful God. He pitied them because of Job, for them to do those sacrifices that he has forgiven them. Praise the Lord, somebody. This is Job. We have saw the pain and sorrow he passed through. But yet, Christ in him gave him the glory. The end, the Bible said, God doubled all those things for him. I don't know whatever you are passing through. I don't know the trial that you are passing through. But I'm here to encourage you once again that Christ in you is the hope of glory. But God is asking me, sending me to come and tell you this hour, whatever you are still carrying, let God Almighty Spirit come and dwell in you to remove all those things from you. Jacob collected all those things from there in the book of Genesis chapter 35 verse 2 and 3. They buried all those things. Still that is not of God, brothers and sisters in the Lord. Bury them so that Christ in you will yield the hope of glory. As you look unto God, as you walk in his principle, as you walk in his rules and his regulation, even though they prepare a table before you in the book of Psalm 23 verse 4, God is there to rescue you. Even though you walk through the valley of shadow of death in the verse 3 of Psalm 23, you will never fear evil because Christ in you is the hope of glory. I'm here once again, brothers and sisters, to use these scriptures to encourage you, for you to be bold and courageous, as Joshua said in the book of Joshua chapter 1. God said to Joshua, he said, be bold and courageous. Be bold. When you are bold, that is Christ in you. We all saw example of Medrash, Shadrach, and Abednego. I always use this example often in my many previous episodes. They were in exile under the leadership of King Nebuchadnezzar. But Christ is there, gave them that hope of glory. They were so having that great faith and boldness and confidence. Christ in you is the hope of glory. When King Nebuchadnezzar told them to bow to the pole of the gold, they said even though they are thrown into that lake of fire, they will never bow. Christ in them, if at all they burn, they know they are going to make heaven. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, this is not time we should allow the things of the world, negative things, to make us not to make heaven. Allow Christ to come and dwell in you. Have that great faith. Let us go to the book of Philippians. We will see what Apostle Paul said. He said, let me read it to your hearing. Praise the Lord, somebody. Amen. In the book of Philippians chapter 3, if you read from verse 12 to 14, it said, not that I have already obtained all this, or I have already been made perfect, but I press on to take hold of that for which Christ Jesus took hold of me. 13, brothers, I do not consider myself yet to have taken hold of it, but one thing I do, forgetting what is behind and straining towards what is ahead, I press on towards the goal to win the prize for which God has called me heavenward in Christ Jesus. Amen, somebody. This is exactly what Medrash, Shadrach, and Abednego did when they were confronted to bow for the pole of the gold which King Nebuchadnezzar made to call his God. He refused to bow. They refused to bow. They believe in what they have not yet seen, that they are going to make heaven if they did not bow for that pole, to that pole. Praise the Lord, somebody. And really, they were thrown into fire. But Christ in them gave them that hope of glory. The Bible said the fourth person was inside that fire. And making Nebuchadnezzar to say they should release them. They don't want that fire. But Christ, because of that great faith and boldness and confidence, Christ in you, I don't know what you are passing through. They were not born and they were released. Praise the Lord, somebody. This very scripture, the book of Philippians chapter 3, when we just read just now, we saw how Paul the Apostle said that he is walking towards the goal. Not that he has achieved it, but he believed in Christ Jesus. He used his mouth now. After believing it, he used his mouth to confess, to say it out to the hearing of the word that he is not afraid of the ashamed of the gospel. That Christ in him is the hope of glory. That he is pressing towards the goal. He has not yet seen it, but he said he's going to leave all those things. And this scripture in this book of Philippians chapter 3, which Apostle Paul, I just read now, wrote, says, it has a song that says, this one thing I do, forget about the past, I press on towards the goal, for a victorious crown. This one thing I do, forget about the past, I press on towards the goal, for a victorious crown. One thing, this one thing I do, forget about the world, I press on towards the goal, for a victorious crown. This one thing I do, forget about the world, I press on towards the goal, for a victorious crown. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, this is time for you to forget about all those things. Things that are not relevant. Don't allow what you are seeing around you to make you not to serve God the way you want to serve God. We saw examples of Apostle Paul. He was in the prison. In the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 6, if you read from verse 9 to 10, the Bible said, even if as he was in the prison, because he was a shepherd for the Lord, doing this work of evangelism, he was being arrested, but yet in the prison, the Bible said Apostle Paul was still writing to people that are not in the prison. But if it was to be me and you today, maybe we would be sad, we would be having grievances, just as John the Baptist did in the book of Matthew chapter 11. This is time for we to have that great faith, that boldness that Medrash, Shadrach, and Abednego have, the boldness that faith and faith that Job was having when he was passing through pain and sorrow. He lost all the material things and all the children. But yet, he mentioned in the book of Job chapter 29 verse 3 that his lamp is on my head and the light will walk me out of darkness. Really, what he pronounced with his mouth came to manifestation. The Bible said God bless him double portion, double fold of what he has losing. Praise the Lord, somebody. Christ in you is the hope of glory. I'm here to use all these things to encourage you. It is time for we to look unto Jesus alone. The book of Hebrews chapter 12. Hebrews chapter 12 verse 2 says we should look unto Jesus alone. We should not allow material things to be distracting us from not serving God the way God wants us to serve Him. When we walk in His obedience and His principle, when we abide in His truth, when we allow that Christ to be dwelling in us, we will come out victorious. Christ in you, the hope of glory. I don't know the challenges you are passing through. I have seen testimony. People who are looking for the fruit of the womb after 15 years, after 18 years, they have triplets, twins, etc. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, we should believe that God is real. His word is here. Amen. I don't know. Don't believe that somebody cursed you. Go and read the book of, Numbers chapter 23 and the whole of 24. You will see how a man called Balaam. He called Balaam that he should come and curse the children of Israel. But the Bible said, anytime this guy wants to curse them, the word that is prophesying coming out of his mouth, it is blessing, blessing. You are a blessed person, you are not a cursed person. Your imagination will put you to that condition you are in right now. If you think you are poor, you have poor mentality. I don't know whatever you are thinking that you are. It is your thought. It is not what God says about you. He said he's there for you 24 hours. We have read the book of Isaiah chapter 43, 1 to 3. We have read the book of Psalm 23. We read verse 3 and 4. All these things, because this is not time. We should be using our mind, our sense, our idea to be drawing ourselves backward. It is time we leave all those things behind. In the book of the same Isaiah chapter 43 verse 18, it said we should leave behind all those things. All those things that are past, any character we are exhibiting that is not pleasing to God, that is not making the blessings of God to shower upon us, we should leave them behind. That is why I read the book of Genesis chapter 35. I read verse 2 to 4 to you, that God spoke to Jacob, that all those things they are carrying, serving idol, different character, things that is not pleasing to him, they should bury them. And really, the children of Israel, they gave all to Jacob, and he buried them there in Bethel. And in a chamber, I'm sorry, he went to Bethel, where they are serving Christ. Christ in you, the hope of glory. Mothers, last time I spoke about, can we continue in sin and ask for his grace? But the Bible says, shall we continue in sin? But I put it in my own way, can we continue in sin? No way. Mothers, if you go to the book of Ephesians, go and read there. Chapter 6, go and read, you will see they are in there. It said we should not put our children to anger. The same way our children should obey us, we have to come together. Because in Amos 3:3, we can never agree until we come together as one. We should try to be together as one. Our God is real. He said, is there anything too hard for him? Is there anything too hard? Luke 1:37. With God, all things are possible. But with men, it might be impossible. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, let us believe in those things we've not seen. This is Paul speaking. He said, this one thing I do, forget about the world, pressing towards the goal to achieve that crown of heaven. I am here once again with this scripture to encourage you with the spirit of boldness and having great faith in God to walk in righteousness. Even though the book of, I think Ephesians said it, that all these enemies, they are walking, they are not ordinary, because in spiritual there is no friend. But when you put God first, when you don't carry all these cockroaches with you, and you bury them, you leave them behind by biting, oppressing, hatred, witchcraft. Not that you are dealing with people. People God created you with, they are the children of God, and you are going to the church of God to pray. Many people are looking for the fruit of the womb. Many, they are looking for healing. But when they see people discussing about somebody like them, they will use their mouth to destroy that person. The same mouth they are going to use to pray. May God forgive us in Jesus' name. Christ in you, the hope of glory. We have seen all this example. It is not my word. It is the word of God. We have seen all these things. Esther prayed and God answered his prayer. Christ in her, it was the hope of their glory. Enemy that wanted to kill them was put into death. We saw Medra, Shadrach, and Abednego in the book of Daniel, chapter 1 and 2. Huh? They did not die. The enemy that lied on their head, they were thrown, they were died. They all died. Even in Daniel's home, He somehow had confidence in God. He believed in God. Christ in Daniel was the hope of his glory. He was thrown into a den of a lion, but yet God Almighty delivered him from out of that lion's den. The enemy that lied against him was put in there and was born. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, somebody. We saw Paul and Silas. They so had confidence because they were doing the things of God. Christ in you, the hope of glory. They were put in prison. They prayed and they were later released. People who saw the actions of God through them gave their life to Christ. This is Christ in you, the hope of glory. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, this is a new year, new era. Let us leave those things behind. As Apostle Paul said in the book of Philippians chapter 3, that this one thing I do, pursuing the goal, leaving all those things behind, it is time for we to come together as one. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, let us love one another. Be real, don't have a double face, please. And be careful. Wherever you go, be careful. Let the Spirit of God lead you. Be careful. I want to leave you here. I believe with this little word of exhortation, you can rewind it over and over again, reading the scripture, putting them into practice, Christ in you, the hope of glory. Don't allow whatever you are seeing to be detecting for you. These are challenges, but God is real. All these things you are seeing, they will come to pass. But heaven and earth will go, but the word of God will remain. Brothers and sisters in Lord, Christ is in you. It will give you hope of glory. If you walk in His principle, if you walk in His commandment, no matter the challenges you are passing through, you remind Him. If you are praying, you are praying, your prayer is not being answered. He said in the book of Isaiah chapter 43 verse 26 that we should bring Him to remembrance. All those things He spoke about us, He said we should bring Him to remembrance. God will make it real for you. Don't be afraid of the witches and wizards. If you see them accountable for, as I earlier said, my previous episode, began to use the word of God, pray. They don't have a foundation. You are not a cursed person, you are a blessed person. Go and read the book of all the Numbers 23 and all the 24. You will see who wanted to curse the children of God. But the man he went to go and meet is a child of God, is a servant of God. Then the power of God was releasing prophecy of blessing. You are a blessed person. Go to Isaiah 43. All he said about you 1 to 3. Remind him, forget about the old things. Press towards the goal. The challenges you are passing through, you will not die. If you are looking for a fruit of the womb, it will come. I'm a living testimony. I have a very, very big and a chronic sickness. But I was surprised. The sickness left. People were telling me to be praying and fasting. I started committing myself to the things of God. Being a shepherd for God. Following His rules and regulations. The sickness was cured, not knowing I was still eating medicine. They changed medicine for me. But until after 9 years, I was being told that the sickness is gone the year 2004. And this thing started the year 1992. This made me to hold on to my faith. I don't know the challenges that are confronting you. I don't know that enemy that are confronting you, that are threatening your life. But I'm here to tell you, Christ in you is the hope of glory. Even though you walk through the valley of shadow of death, fear no evil. His rod and His staff is with you. Christ in you is the hope of glory. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, let us make peace. Let us love one another. Let us abide by the rules and regulations. Let us use the word of God in the book of Genesis chapter 35 verse 2 to 4. To leave all those things that is not of God. He will not allow us to see the blessing and the glory of God. We should not be using man to be bypassing the children of God. We should be real. If somebody offends us, let us come up openly. Talk to that person, even though you vibrate. As I spoke last time, concerning can God, can we continue in sin? The Bible said in the book of the same Ephesians, I think chapter 24, go and read from verse 27 there or 26. It said we should be annoyed, but we should not let it over-escalate. React, but stop. Praise the Lord, somebody. So with all this, I believe you are convinced that Christ in you is the hope of glory. Don't be afraid. Be bold and courageous, as He said in the book of Joshua chapter 1. Move on. No matter what is confronting you, no matter the challenges you are passing through, Christ in you, brother. Christ in you. Christ in you. In Medrash, Shadrach, and Abednego. They succeeded. They did not go into that fire. King Nebuchadnezzar put them. Christ in you. Daniel did not burn. He did not die in the hands of the lion. Christ in you. Medrash, Shadrach, and Abednego, they were free. Christ in you. Paul and Absalom were released in prison. Christ in you. Esther was set free. And Haman was put into death. Christ in you is the hope of your glory. No matter what is confronting you, is it sickness? Is it barrenness? Are you looking for a job? Are you looking for a hope? I don't know what you are looking for. Christ in you, brother. Christ in you is the hope of glory. I say, remain blessed until I call your way again. For in Jesus' name, I have prayed. Amen, somebody.